We are into April. It is a beautiful day in Edmonton. So, wherever you're joining us, hopefully you're having a wonderful time. Welcome to our Thursday night travel talks. Today we are featuring Uniworld River Cruises and Insight Vacations. For any of you who have not been on a Zoom call before, everyone is muted. You do have control of your video on or off. I'm finding that we're so disconnected from each other. So I urge you to put your videos on so we can see your lovely faces. We do have a chat feature in Zoom as well. So if you do have any questions, please put them into the chat and we will answer them at the end of the presentation. My name is Lisa Antlik. I'm one of the consultants of Expedia Cruises. And tonight's travel talk is being hosted by the Six Edmonton Expedia Cruises locations and in the Edmonton area and vicinity. We started these travel talks months ago when COVID started to educate you, to let you know what's happening into the travel industry, and to help you plan for future vacations. And I was reminded today that there is a difference between traveling and booking and dreaming. So it is not safe to travel right now. We're not encouraging that, but we are encouraging you to dream of your future vacations and to start thinking about booking. So it is 1 year that we've passed that travel has shut down. And if you're on this call, you probably love to travel. Travel fulfills this. It's why we do it. And if you're like me, you're missing it. And this is probably the longest that I've gone without using my passport and using my suitcase. And I have to tell you, I can't wait to start traveling again when it's safe. Lots of news about vaccines and rollouts, and I'm optimistic that if once we start getting more and more people vaccinated, that travel will begin. Most of us on this call either know that they can get vaccinated or have already had their first shot or have it scheduled. I got my first shot 2 weeks ago, and I can't tell you how excited I am to start. So our Expedia offices are open here and here for you right now. Due to restrictions with COVID, we're asking for you to call or email us to make an appointment. Our consultants are here to help you not only plan your bucket list, but also help you navigate travel because it will look different as we get into it in the near future. So right now, I'd like you to sit back, relax, and enjoy. I'm going to introduce you to our special guest, Brad Gibson, Business Development Manager of Uniworld River Cruises and Insight Vacations, who's going to share information on the wonderful products he represents. So welcome, Brad.
Thank you so much, Lisa, and everyone at Expedia. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for taking the time to join us tonight. We're going to go on a little journey, if we will. And invite you to come along. So for tonight's event, we're going to go through and talk about Uniworld River Cruises, what makes us unique and special as far as traveling experiences. I'd like to highlight a couple of our itineraries, our sailings, Paris and Normandy in France, and the enchanting Danube, the beautiful Danube River, and we'll have a look at that. And then also, if you have consideration sometimes to combine a river cruise experience with a guided land journey or as a separate vacation, we'll also highlight another brand that I look after in the Travel Corporation, and that is Insight Vacations. So kick back and relax, and we will jump right in and enjoy our journey. I think very much so, river cruising is certainly one of the best ways of cruising, and Uniworld is the finest of the river cruise lines, offering a truly luxurious experience. River cruising gives you all the benefits and advantages of typical cruising, if you will. Unpack once, you can relax. On the rivers, you have ever-changing scenery, and you will visit key iconic cities, but hidden gems in the countryside along the rivers as well. So there's so much to experience along the way. We are so proud of what we deliver for our guests on Uniworld, and it truly is all-inclusive. We have incredible service that we offer. Excursions with a choice included, five-star farm-to-table dining. It's all included in the price up front. So you have your gratuities, unlimited pours of wine, spirits, beers, and all the wonderful experiences you have along the way. If you're active, there's fitness centers on certain of the ships and bicycles You can do some fantastic bike rides along the edge of the rivers, both on your own or part of a guided experience, and also Nordic walking sticks. There's so much to do and see on all of these journeys. I want you to think of Uniworld as floating boutique hotels. I mentioned that we're part of the Travel Corporation, and one of our sister brands is Red Carnation Hotels. Very unique, very distinct properties, very highly rated, and Uniworld very much mirrors that experience. So each ship is very unique and distinct in and of itself, and is meant to reflect the destinations and the rivers that we're sailing in. We love to have our guests offshore having incredible experiences, but then coming back on the ship and feeling like royalty and still in that European feel along the way. So very unique, each and every ship that we offer. We're so proud of our crew on board. They truly provide outstanding service. They're the best of the best. They're very well trained. And as we like to say, no request is too large, no detail is too small. We are all a family, and when our guests come on board, you are part of that family. As I mentioned as well, unlimited pours, so all your favorite premium wines, beers, and spirits are available for you. And the cuisine, I have to tell you, is second to none. It is, we have incredible chefs and staff aboard, and it is five-star farm-to-table cuisine as we go along, very much reflecting what is in season, what is part of that destination, and our chefs stop at markets along the way. Everything's locally sourced, and we can accommodate most any meal requests or dietary restrictions, so you can come on board and truly relax and enjoy. And I always find that food is such a big part of the travel experience. So when you're on board with us, you will get truly unique European cuisine or wherever you're traveling in the world with us, and our incredible experiences. Why do we travel? Well, one of the biggest reasons is to get away, see places that we're not as familiar with, and have these incredible experiences. And all the experiences on Uniworld have been very carefully curated. We also offer a choice most days, so it's all included, but not everyone's the same, so you can choose from different things. The picture here reflecting along the rivers, I'll give you an example, and later on as well, of visiting a saffron grower, which is very unique for Europe, along the Danube, or going to an organic vineyard and having a wine tasting. But there's just dozens and dozens of great experiences along the way, and things that are exclusive to Uniworld as well. Morning with the Masters quite often will be, we're going to visit, in this case in Amsterdam, one of the famous art galleries, or going over to Burano, the beautiful island in the Lagoon of Venice, small, much quieter than Venice, the multicolored buildings. Let's Go are more active inclusions that we offer. And in this case here, if you look in the bottom right-hand corner, golfing. Yes, actually the chance to go golfing on a river cruise. This is up in the very northern part of France, and we'll talk about it when we get to the Paris and Normandy itinerary that we offer. But there are lots of unique experiences, and if golfing is not your thing, well, while we're doing that, other people can be sightseeing as well. So the choice is yours. Just to give you a very quick glance of where we do sailing. So all throughout Europe, we're the only operator in Italy on the Po River. So that's one to keep in mind as well. But all the main rivers in Europe, we're proud to offer. And then what we call our exotics in different places around the world. Egypt, one of my favorite places. And Egypt is open. We've had, there's people traveling into Egypt right now. Iceland is another one. It's starting, you know, and that's the way it will be for a while. But as Lisa mentioned at the beginning, it's not so much traveling right now, but it's getting fully invested in the dreaming and the fun that is travel, and then getting ready to make a decision on what you'd like to do. Because the one thing that we know and we've seen, and I keep in touch with a lot of people in the industry, is things are really selling quite well for next year. So we want to make sure, always the saddest thing in my life is when I'm talking to one of the Expedia consultants and they have you as their clients, but they can't find space on something. So that's something to keep a note out for as well. So what's new going into this year? Well, we have a few new ships that we're very proud of. The Mekong Jewel, which actually debuted last January, but didn't get along too far until the shutdown. Beautiful ship. and then the São Gabriel in Portugal for the beautiful Douro River Valley. Love Venezia, and if you see the picture behind me here, I would like to say this is my dining room or my kitchen, but this is actually one of the dining experiences on our ship La Venezia. It's brand new in Italy, and this is the La Cantinetta, the cellar dining room on that ship, and it's just beautiful. And then last but not least, the SS Sphinx. So the super ship Sphinx is brand new. We'll start sailing this year on the Nile, and there's just nothing more elegant and stylish than that particular ship, and Egypt is such a wonderful destination. Another thing that we've brought out new starting later this year and then into next year and beyond is the combination of cruise and rail. And we've had an extremely high interest in this already. It's already only been out for about 6 weeks now. But what we've done is combined in certain areas of Europe, our Uniworld luxury river cruises with Golden Eagle luxury trains. So there's a few examples that you can do. When I was talking about Northern Italy on the Po River, one journey is to go from Venice up through Switzerland, Austria into Zurich. And you can also go into, you can do it either direction. And then there's also off of the Danube, you can do a train journey into Romania, Transylvania and Dracula. There's a lot of, or several different options to consider. And the longest one, if you want to go for a good long journey, is right across Russia. We offer from Moscow to Vladivostok on the other side of Russia as a luxury train journey. We have our own dining car on this. And Uniworld, the founder of Uniworld is Mrs. B. Tolman. The Travel Corporation is owned, privately run, privately owned by the Tolman family. And Mrs. Tolman is a wonderful chef, and she is very much behind the design and decor and the feel of Uniworld, but she has some great recipes as well. And we will have that incorporated onto the train experience as well. So that's something that if you're interested, please reach out to your Expedia consultant and they can help you guide through that. So I'd like to take you on a little journey on Paris and Normandy. Paris is actually the city for me in Europe that I've been to more than any other one, and I love it every time. As we say, this is a journey steeped in wonder, and it has, obviously, Paris is such a key city in Europe, but then going through the beautiful countryside, sailing north up to Normandy. And the ship that we use on this particular sailing is the super ship Joie de Vivre. And the Joie de Vivre, its decor is very much inspired by 1920s Art Deco Paris. So it's a very unique feel and it's just such a stunning ship. So as we go along on this is a 7-night cruise. You can see we've got meals included, your excursions, one private experience, and a UNESCO heritage site to boot. So this is just an overview of the itinerary that we're going to do our sailing on. And we sail up north and then we do a few excursions from our base in the northern part of France. So when you arrive, you'll be met and transferred from the airport right to the ship. And the beauty of river cruising and the beauty of Uniworld is that our ship docks right in the center of Paris, and it does in most any city or town. And that means incredibly easy access to things. We're not sort of on the outskirts or somewhere far away where we have to commute in and out. The ship docks right in the center and actually not far from the Eiffel Tower at all. So we'll come on board, we'll have our first night, you can relax, have a nice dinner, and then we go straight from there, we start sailing north. And one of the places that we visit early on is Giverny. And this is famous for the well-known impressionist Claude Monet, the painter. And he did many, many paintings of his beautiful gardens. So a chance just to soak in the beauty of the French countryside, it really ties into a special part of history as well. We also go up to Rouen, which is up in the northern, towards the northern part of France, and a very historic town. The list of people who lived there or died there is quite long, but we've got Richard the Lionheart and Joan of Arc. And it's a beautiful town. There's also a very famous church there that Monet painted as well, dozens of times. And this is where we can make our excursions to maybe go golfing. So again, up on the northern part of France, you can do that, or you can stay in Honfleur and do a guided walking tour around this beautiful seaside town, and you can see the beautiful colored buildings there. So there's something for everyone when you travel with Uniworld. And this is just to give you an idea, that's the famous clock that Monet painted many times. And Rouen is such a beautiful little town and so much history that it's steeped in as well. You'll certainly have a wonderful time exploring there. And then as we sail back down towards Paris, just on the outskirts of Paris, of course, is Versailles, the palace of Louis XIV, the Sun King. And we offer a couple of options here. And one of the nice things with Uniworld is we have very specific VIP entrance. So certainly no waiting in line. And we can also access areas of the palace that are not typical for regular tourists. So one of the options we have is the secret apartments of the Palace of Versailles, and then also the option for a beautiful gardens tour. And it's one of my favorite things. I've been lucky enough to go, I've been to Versailles, but some of the main palaces in Europe. And sometimes the outside is just as fascinating as the inside, but there's something to explore for everyone. And then we're back in Paris. And again, we're docked right in the center of the city. And if you've been to Paris before, if you haven't and you're dreaming of it, I hope that you get the chance to go. The Eiffel Tower is lit up in the evening, and then every hour on the hour, it twinkles and all the lights glitter and glimmer, and we're right there. And then we have a day in Paris to do exploring. So we give you some choice of excursions there too. You can remember that you have the bicycles on board if you want to go for a bike ride through the left bank of Paris. That's something that you can do as well, or go on a guided walking tour through some of the more well-known neighborhoods as well. So there's just an incredible amount to see and do and explore on that, on the beautiful ship, the Joie de Vivre. Now we're going to shift over to the Danube, the Blue Danube. This is a beautiful sailing. And what we're starting out here is in Budapest in Hungary. And we will sail through Hungary into Austria. We will have the stunning Wachau Valley and then finish up just tucking into Germany. And we end up in Passau as well. So enjoy this. Now, we went from 1920s Art Deco inspired on the France itinerary to now we are in the land of the Habsburgs. So this ship is named after none other than Maria Theresa, the super ship Maria Theresa. This is a picture of the lobby and the staircase. You can see from the decor coming around, this is actually a picture from the Christmas market. So that's always a very special time to visit Europe if you're ever interested in that. So we like decorate things up to match up with the festive mood. There's always fresh flowers on board and such welcoming staff as well. And just give you an idea of some of the staterooms that we have on board. And again, so unique and distinct. And again, I look at it so much as I love traveling for so many reasons. One is to get away and have things that are different. And that's what I love about our ships, is that you feel like you're still in sort of historic Europe as you're sailing along, but all the most latest technology, modern amenities you can imagine, and you're so well looked after throughout your sailing as well. So lots to pick and choose from. This is one of our cafes on board the ship, and this is the Habsburg's Lounge, such a beautiful part of the ship. So when we start out, in this case, we're in Budapest. So when we have our first venture out into the city after our first night on board, we'll take you around the city. This is Heroes Square on the Pest side, and commemorating some of the most iconic figures in their history. It's a wonderful experience. And then we cross over, and this is a photo. Several of these are photos of mine from sailing along the Danube. This is taken up on Gellert Hill. So we're looking down onto the Danube, and you can see across the river, a little on the right there, the biggest building of the Parliament building. And Budapest was two different cities or two different towns across the Danube. So I'm standing, taking the picture on the Buda side, which is more hilly, and then across is a little bit more flat area, and that's Pest. So you have a chance to do some exploring on both sides of the river. I love Budapest for so many reasons. It's got a beautiful energy about it, and there's some great shopping and some great dining experiences to be had as well. We're going to sail down the river, and we're heading into Austria almost and getting close to Vienna, but we stop in Bratislava in the Slovak region, and it's, I remember being on this sailing and thinking, I wasn't quite sure what to expect, to be honest with you, what type of city this would be. And it's a very charming, smaller city, Bratislava is. Again, it's got sort of a youthful energy. It's got very much sort of an art scene going on as well. This is the old National Gallery. There's a newer one now. Nice to see that. And then this is sort of three shots in one. But you can see that the wonderful Mozart was a little boy. He grew up in Salzburg, but once he was six, he hit the road. He actually went on the road to take his music, and his first stop was in Bratislava. So they have a plaque commemorating that. You can see some of the charming walkways that you have there. And then on the right-hand side, sort of again, the artistic side of Bratislava, that's a statue of Andy Warhol. And when the picture here, you can see him inside. I've got one where he was positioned outside. They kind of move him about. And then this happy fellow coming right out of the sewer grate to greet us as we're walking along, mind your step. And then from there, going into Vienna. And Vienna is such a beautiful city, and I call it sort of a stately city. The two pictures, there's three pictures together here. The two on the left-hand side are the same street, but it's combining two photos together, so to speak. But some beautiful thoroughfares and walkways. Vienna is the home, the king of the cafe culture. So I always recommend, highly recommend that you stop at one of the cafes and have a true Viennese experience there and wander the streets. We will, of course, take you on guided experiences, but you'll have time on your own as well. And again, because we're docked right central, it's easy to come and go from the ship. And of course, the gold statue of Strauss in one of the beautiful parks in central Vienna as well as one that I had to get a photo of for myself. After we leave Vienna, really now we're more in the Wachau Valley, which is very renowned for its beauty, but we're getting the hidden gems, small places along the way. So one of the stops, Dürnstein, absolutely beautiful. And this is where I was mentioning a little bit earlier, we have a choice of excursions, and one is a saffron grower, which is very, very unique for that part of the world. So they discovered through history that this was actually grown centuries ago. So there's a couple there that have started it back up. They've been growing saffron. That's one option, or the organic vineyard. And time, again, is always just to wander the charming small town and enjoy. You might want to get one of the bicycles and go for a ride. There's so many different options that you can do. And as we sail along, there's times that we sail overnight while we're sleeping, but going through the Wachau Valley, a lot of it during the daytime, we want to see the beautiful scenery. And it just, as you're on board and you can, the choice of what you want to do, lots of people like to sit up on the sun deck, or you might want to take a break and treat yourself to a spa. You're on vacation, so time to relax and pamper yourself. This is the pool on the SS Maria Theresa. It's just absolutely stunning. And you can see, you can just sit and relax in the pool and enjoy the views out the window, or head up onto the top deck and our staff is just a call away. They'll be checking on you, anything you need. Again, no request too large, no detail too small. We're there to look after you. You are our family and our guests while you're on board Uniworld. Later on, we get to Linz. And I put this picture in here, and I would say it's not that it's so much anything so remarkable about the photo, other than to say that this is where we dock. So when you dock, and I love, love, love river cruising for the simplicity. It doesn't have sort of the complex production of bigger ships getting on and off. It's so easy, and we're right there. So just to the left on the picture is sort of the main town square. So off we just walk right off, and we're ready to go. Came into the square, and I remember coming through here, and there's a crowd of gentlemen having some life-size chess game. And I love to soak in the atmosphere and any chance I have to interact with the locals, but just people watching and seeing what people are doing is always a big part of the experience for me. And what do you do when you go to Linz, or what is it known for? Well, one thing of many is the famous Linzer Tort. So we actually get a chance to see how they make it. And then they bake it up. And of course, we're going to sample some and enjoy that and culinary experiences, whether we're on board, of course, but off the ship as well. There's so much to enjoy on the culinary side of things as well. And then again, I mentioned with the bicycles, if it's something that you enjoy, you'll love it. And again, we offer sometimes like a let's go experience, which would be guided. But the beauty in a lot of the rivers in Europe is there's flat pathways along the edge. So it's an easy ride and you can go for your own bike ride as well. And that gets you sort of a different view and a different sight on some of the places that we're sailing along as well. You can do morning yoga on the top deck as well. I talked about the fitness center. So all things that are available for you, we're all different. Everyone will do their own thing as they see fit. We do want to let you know that you can book and cruise with confidence. We have some incredible well-being measures in place for our guests. Once you're board again, and you can relax and enjoy knowing that you're going to be very well taken care of. And the world is a beautiful place, and we're so proud to have the Treadright Foundation is part of the Travel Corporation. We're a founding member. And the Treadright Foundation is not-for-profit, and it's all about sustainable travel. There's three pillars. That's wildlife, people, and the planet. And we're very focused in on each. And we actually incorporate what we call Make Travel Matter experiences into our trips where they match up. But one of the things that we've did over 10 years ago is a Clean Rivers campaign, which many other operators have joined in on. We want to make sure that we preserve these beautiful places for generations to come. We've also are working towards banning all single-use plastics, not only on our ships and our different trips, but also in our offices around the world. We want to make sure that we're good stewards of the environment. And again, so that our kids and our grandkids and our great-grandkids are able to have the same experiences that we have as well. We do have an offer that's available to you right now for sailings into next year in 2022. And that is making a booking by the end of June. You'll save 10% on select departures. So you do need to check with your Expedia consultant and they can guide you through that process as well. But that can offer some incredible savings. So when you're comfortable, you're going to dream and then you have to plan. When you're ready to make a decision, please let them know and we'd be so excited to have you with us. And then as well, for taking the time this evening to join us. We have an extra offer that's exclusive through Expedia Cruises in Edmonton and area, and that will save you an additional $250 per person after tonight. That's good until next Friday. So if that's something that you're ready for in the short term, please consider it, and that will offer you some additional savings as well. So that is our sailing along the rivers with Uniworld, and I hope you see that there's an awful lot of thought and attention and detail put into our trips, and we will look after you and give you a truly luxurious experience when you're on vacation. Now, depending on what your travels have been, many people love to do river cruising, but we also have land guided vacations. And one of the things that's such a benefit right off the bat, I'm switched now over to Insight Vacations. So part of the Travel Corporation, a different brand in the travel marketplace, and we do escorted group journeys. So throughout Europe, Britain, and what we call ancient civilizations, which would be the Eastern Mediterranean, Greece, Turkey, Israel, Jordan, Egypt, Morocco, and then other places. We have trips in North America and starting new in South America as well. One of the instant benefits on this side is the fact that we really go everywhere. So it's something that to consider if you can't get to it from the oceans or from the rivers, rest assured with Insight Vacations, we can get you there. The photos shown here are all pictures that our guests have posted on Instagram with the hashtag Insight Moments and just having wonderful. And every time I look at these, I just almost want to cry because I just want to travel again so much. So we invite you to get back to what you love, what we all love. Certainly those of us in the industry, and you're on this because you have a passion for travel as well. And we can't wait to get back to it as well. So with Insight in the world of escorted journeys, we have a smaller group camaraderie. We take less people on our trips than is standard, and we have customized luxury coaches as well that we use throughout Europe and North America. And we're very proud to offer different group sizes as more of an option for you moving forward. So a classic group size, as we call it with Insight, would be our coaches hold exactly 40 people. So that's the maximum you can have. That's less seats on a coach than you'll find anywhere else. So it's double the legroom, double the window, the view, less people on board. We would average about 33 guests. Starting new later this year, once we're up and operating and into next year and beyond, on the same trips, we'll also offer different dates that are maximum 24 guests. So in this case, you're going to get an average of probably 18 to 24 people. It's a nice group size. I always like it because it's not too small, because if you're only a little bit of people, then there's not the luxury vehicle, but also it's so nice to have a little diversity of different types of people that you're traveling with as well. So small group or classic group, either one is fantastic, but the choice is yours. And then something new as well is on any of our departures, you can take it over private with as few as 12 people. So if you have family and friends, or you can make your own group together and you would like that sort of thing, in essence, we'd like to have our own little travel bubble and off we go. Please contact your Expedia consultant. They'll reach out to us and we can organize that for you. Otherwise, I just wanted to give you a quick little sample of some of the itineraries that we do. This is one of our most popular trips year in, year out, the country road to Croatia. We have different types of trips. Country roads is sort of a style or a series that we do, which gets you a combination of the key big cities, but some of the lesser known places as well. And Croatia has been popular for many years now, and it just seems to grow and grow as time goes on. And this gives you, in my opinion, a little bit of everything of Croatia. You have Zagreb, you have Opatija in the north, and Dubrovnik, which is the most famous, and we've got 3 nights in Dubrovnik to relax and soak it in. But then also unique, like beautiful natural places like the Vici Lakes, the Terraced Lakes up towards the north, and the islands, because Croatia is stunning coastline, absolutely stunning, and the islands offer that experience as well. So you can see we have 2 nights each on Hvar and Korčula, so there's different island experiences available as well. So just to give you at least a bit of a sample, here's another new country road trip. This was to be brand new last year, didn't end up happening, so it'll start new later this year, and that is the country roads of Wales, Devon, and Cornwall. And again, the circles with the numbers, that's how many nights you're staying in each place. And this is a beautiful itinerary where we're not really covering a lot of ground, a lot of distance, and it's 2 nights everywhere. So it has a nice even flow about the trip. And it's a beautiful combination of us guiding you and having experiences, but free times to relax and enjoy on your own. The picture here of our happy little sheep is in Brecon Beacons National Park in Wales. Wales is a natural wonder, absolutely stunning. So that's just one thing. Lots of scones and tea and jam and all the good stuff that you would expect on a British trip. And it's just something to consider there as well. And again, places that are not easy to visit or possible to visit off of a river cruise. And we have a couple exciting new trips I'll let you know about as well. Another country roads, I'm really focusing in on this tonight. And that is of Andalusia, the southern province or region in Spain. And what I love about this trip and the next one I'm going to show you is if you've been, and you know, there's lots and lots and lots of people who have been to Spain in one form or another before. And this is such a beautiful trip because it visits lesser known places like Ronda. So it's not just the kind of the main places that you'd visit on a standard itinerary. We've got lots of trips in Spain of all different sorts, but this is a beautiful new one. And then undiscovered Ireland as well. We start and finish in Shannon, actually, on the West Coast, and do a pretty good full loop. It doesn't have Northern Ireland specifically in this particular itinerary. We do it on other ones as well. But if you just take a look through, you know, we're staying just outside of Dublin, but very much on purpose. This trip is to give you the undiscovered, the lesser known places, if you will. The picture as well on this one is our guests learning how to play the national sport of Ireland. And I don't know if you know what it is, but it is called hurling. So hurling is played on a pitch. It's kind of like a lacrosse-ish, but it's the national sport. One of the best teams in the league year in and year out is in Kilkenny. And we do this on this trip and a couple other ones in Ireland. And we take our guests to meet a couple of the players from the best team. And we go out on the pitch, they show us, they tell us exactly the whole story of hurling, how it's played. And then we get a chance to get out there ourselves and just have a bit of fun with it. And there's so much fun and camaraderie on Insight Vacations with the group experience. One of my favorite things is we do a welcome dinner at the beginning of the trip. And that's a chance to have a lovely meal. You're meeting your travel director that'll be with you from start to finish with Insight. They're experts on all the information, the knowledge. They're leading us on this journey. And of course, our travel mates, our friends from around the world who are joining in on this trip. And the welcome dinner is always very nice, but a little bit more reserved, if you will, just from the point of view of we're just meeting each other. So there's some nice friendly conversation going on. By the time near the end of the trip, when we do our celebration dinner, the volume has gone up. There's lots of clinking glasses and friends made that you'll have for the rest of your lives and stay in touch with. It's a wonderful experience. So with that, I would like to say thank you so much. That's just to give you a little taste of Insight. If there's any, either Uniworld or Insight, and you have any questions, please type it in the chat. I'm going to pass it back over to Lisa. And then if there's anything beyond that, all the Expedia consultants know where to reach me, and they can reach out and we can make sure that we get answers to any of your questions. But thank you so much for taking the time this evening.
Thank you, Brad, for sharing with us the world of Uniworld and definitely Insight. And I think, you know, for myself, I'm dying to go somewhere. I have sailed on Uniworld. I did Vienna down to Belgrade, rode the bikes, enjoyed all of it. And so it brings back wonderful memories. So thank you for allowing us to have that. I don't see any questions in the chat box. So I think what we'll just do is finish up, but I just want to remind everybody that although travel is currently paused, the world is going to start traveling again, and it really is time to start thinking about 2022 and 2023. As Brad said earlier, we really are seeing things book up. People have missed 2 years of vacations. There is revenge travel. We want to get out there. We want to do something. We want to go somewhere. I love my home, but I can't wait to get on an airplane. I can't wait to even hear that dreaded safety talk on the airplane that I used to try and close my eyes and sleep through. So I'm missing that. But I want to thank you for your time. Thank you for your past vacations, for your future travels. If you have any questions, please reach out to your consultants. We're here to help you plan your bucket list and go help you go through all the intricacies of travel. Make sure you follow us on Facebook. Check out our YouTube channel where we always record all our presentations. And next week on our travel talk, we're going to be featuring Virgin Voyages, a brand new cruise line that's coming to the market. Very, very different cruise line. So we look forward to having you join us. Thank you so much and have a wonderful evening and a happy Easter weekend. Oh, sorry, just one more question. There are questions. Yeah, are there any discounts, incentives, sales on Insight tours?
There are, absolutely. And if you just check with your Expedia consultant, they can help you out with that. But we have a special, the Get Back to What You Love promotion goes till June the 4th. So there's savings up to $750 per person on that. So absolutely.
There are lots of specials right now, and all of the river cruise lines as well as tour operators are giving very flexible conditions because I know it's still, travel is still unsure. So no risk in booking, no risk in contacting us. We look forward to hearing from you. Wow, now we got more questions. All right, how big are the ships, Brad?
They vary. So from about 120 to 140 guests. Depends on where we're sailing to, but smaller than some of the bigger lines and the highest staff to guest ratio in the industry.
Okay.
And there are brochures online. Yes, you
can. And one of the features that you did talk about is literally docking in the center of the city. So you get off the ship, walk a few steps, and you're in the center of the city.
You're right there.
Yes, you answered that. Brochures are available online.
Yes.
All right. Any other questions?
Gratuities are included. Yes.
Okay.
For Uniworld, everything's built in. If you want to buy a big piece of artwork on the ship, then you might have to pay for that. But other than that, you got everything you need.
All right. Well, we thank you again. Happy Easter. Enjoy your evening. And we look forward to seeing you next week at our weekly travel talks. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. Happy Easter.
Thank you, everybody.